So what we're doing today is building this giant platform that I use to move my shelves up off the ground and give me more storage space. So we're just about to get started. First thing I'm gonna do is take this shelf down that's above me. So the second thing we're gonna do is move that outlet. I kinda wanna move it up a couple inches. I do want to move it down, but I think it's going to be junction between that box and a box we have on the other side. So I don't think I'm going to have a lot of room to play with in that. I might be able to move it up a couple inches, but I don't think I'll be able to move it down about a foot. So we'll see what happens. Maybe I'm lucky. Of course, different screws. Why would we use the same screws on the same projects? Why would we use the same screw for the same project? There's nothing in there. Nothing there. So when we open up the wall, we saw that the cable's running from the top down. So it should be fairly easy just to move the box up. Okay, so we've got the power back on, the box has been moved. I'm gonna leave this bottom spot open in case I wanna move this back down. You know, if I decide to remove the platform at a later date, then it should be just an easy swap. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through and find all the studs. I picked up this Franklin sensor a while back, and it's a really great sensor. It has a little slide out pencil for marking, but it's one of the most accurate ones I've ever seen. And it's only, I think, like 50 bucks. So when you get the really cheap ones for 20 that you can never really guess, this one works great. So I highly recommend it. If you're looking for it, I'm gonna throw a link in the description down below for you guys. The person that built this set of stairs doubled up these 2x10s that go on the 2x6. So I'm not too worried about adding another one to increase its strength. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do joist hangers from here, and then I'm gonna put a 2x8 up against the wall here for me to work from as well. So this will be tied into the wall. I've got a doubled up 2x10 here, and then I'm gonna do 2 foot on center here, so it'll be another one across the middle, and then I'll do bracing in between those 2x8s. So that should give me a pretty solid structure.
Okay.
So from the floor to the top of the beam was 46 and a half, so we want 45 and a half because we're going to lose that inch that the bracket on the floor takes up. So one thing I did is I cut down this 2x4, and that's gonna go right underneath here where that other beam is gonna go across, just to support the weight so it's not relying strictly on the bracket and some nails. So I toenailed the screw in on this side and I just threw a screw in on this side. I haven't secured everything 100% just yet because I want to make sure everything's plumb and even before I go on to securing it, and then we'll build the interior support structure. So I really like the progress. What I'm going to wind up doing is completing this one side, and then I'm going to start building some shelves, at least one set of shelves up here, and then start getting some of the stuff from the move up on the shelf. Allow me to move some stuff around and kind of free up space so I can finish up the second half. So 43 there. So we have our middle beam in. Now we just got to do is add some bracing in between here so we don't get this fun little flex going on. But it shouldn't be too much. The only reason why I'm going like really hardcore with all the bracing and supports and stuff is because it's going to be a storage shelf, so there's going to be weight on it. And I don't know how much it's going to, like the total weight is just going to be constantly sitting on this. So I'd rather be safe than have it collapse in the middle of the night. So far it's pretty good. I'm happy with it. So we'll get the bracing in, we'll get the plywood in, and then we'll be ready to remove this handrail and start putting in our first piece of shelving. And that'll help clean up the garage as we move on to the next section. So what I got here is a little scrap piece of 2x8, and I'm gonna use that to set the joist hangers. So just that way I don't have to mess with the big pieces, trying to hold them in place and all that jazz. Where are you going? Fucking nowheres. So we're all framed up. Now I'm just gonna throw on the piece of plywood and we're gonna be done for the day because it's warm, to say the least. So we'll get this all screwed down and let it cool off a little bit, and then I'll build the shelf and start doing some organizing. That was fucking. There we go. So future me here, I kind of messed up. I had footage recorded from the second day where I finished off this half of the build and I installed the doggy door in the wall. Unfortunately, before I went to DragonCon, I formatted the SD card and I thought I transferred the files over, but I didn't. So it's done. So I'll walk you through a little bit of what I've got here. So I've kind of got storage for screws and power tools. I don't really have a storage space for hand tools like shovels, sledgehammers, axes, things like that. I've got a space to work out. I've also got some stuff that needs to be hung up, like my bottle opener, my dartboard, and things like that. But that will come as I tweak the space a little bit and get things more dialed in. But right now I'm really happy with where we're at. So now we can start using the space and not tripping over everything. So thanks for hanging out with me on this journey, and hopefully I'll see you next time.